Halo, apa kabar? Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat datang di kuliah kita hari ini. Hari ini kita akan membahas tentang Hazard Assessment, Prevention, and Control. Saya Ratna Sari Dewi dari Laboratorium Ergonomi dan Perancangan Sistem Kerja, Departemen Teknik Sistems dan Industri, Institut Teknologi 10 November. Kita akan mulai dengan satu pertanyaan, yaitu what's occupational hazard? Jadi apa itu the occupational hazard? Teman-teman sekalian, occupational hazard is anything at your workplace that can hurt you both physically and mentally. Safety hazard are those that can cause accidents and injuries. Jadi secara definisi sangat sederhana. Jadi apapun yang menyebabkan kita terluka baik secara fisik maupun mental di tempat kerja kita, maka itu disebut sebagai occupational hazard. Jika teman-teman berjalan ke sebuah pabrik atau company secara umum, teman-teman akan menemukan banyak sekali hazard simbol. Seperti yang sebelah sini ada exclamation mark, ada tanda bahaya. Kemudian di sebelah ujung sini ada ecotoxic, ada yang menunjukkan bahwa di sekitar daerah di mana tempat teman-teman berada banyak terdapat zat beracun begitu. Kemudian ada health hazard, ada flammable, ada flame over circle dan seterusnya. So if you visit a company or a factory, you can really easy or you can frequently see this kind of hazard symbols. So it's referred to that actually you are not in a safe positions, right? You are not in a safe locations because something in your surrounding actually contain hazard. Ya, jadi kalau kita menemukan tanda-tanda bahaya seperti ini, artinya sebenarnya kita sedang di lokasi yang tidak aman karena di sekeliling kita ada satu, dua, atau beberapa potensi bahaya. Oke, kalau kita bicara tentang bahaya, maka yang harus dilakukan adalah melakukan pengontrolan gitu, atau istilahnya hazard preventions. Nah, dari sekian banyak teknik pengkontrolan hazard, banyak kita bisa klasifikasikan menjadi lima ini, yang kita sebut sebagai hierarchy of control. Hierarki tertinggi adalah eliminations, kemudian yang paling bawah substitutions, engineering control, administrative control, dan personal protective equipment. Oke, teman-teman pasti sudah familiar dengan what is personal protective equipment. So you guys, I guess you guys should be familiar with what is personal protective equipment. It's safety vest, safety goggle, earmuff, earplug, and so on. So basically, the personal protective equipment protect worker with personal protective equipment for their job, for when they're doing their job. For administrative control improvement in the way work is done. For example, you guys doing some shift work arrangement, and then engineering control. Physical chains that reduce exposure isolate worker from hazard. For example, you using the safeguard, you protect your machine using a certain device, which allow you allow the worker to cover the machine to protect the worker while doing their job on the machine. So the next one is substitution. Substitution is replaced with less hazardous conditions. In some case, for example, you have two kind of materials. The A materials are safer in terms that they contain less toxic toxic element, then you need to change, you need to replace the original the initial materials that contain more toxic elements into the one that's safer. And the highest one is the eliminations. Eliminate or remove the hazard from the workplace entirely. So if you know that there is some potential hazard in the company, then you need to remove, or if it's possible, then remove all the hazard or remove the machine, the materials. You don't use it anymore because you know that there's a very hazardous. So what interesting about this hierarchy is it's kind of how to say, it's like upside down, right? Like a pyramid that is it's not like Egypt pyramid, right? This is like upside down pyramid. Why it's placed in that way? Why it's like upside down? It flip it pyramid. So it shows actually the suggestion how frequent you need to use this kind of hierarchy of the controls. So if you see in the offer here, this there is a scale from most effective, reliable, sustainable to the less reliable, effective, reliable, and sustainable. It means that if you go through from personal protective equipment to the eliminations, actually elimination is the most effective, reliable, and sustainable hazard controls, while the personal protective equipment is less effective, reliable, and sustainable. So in terms of the frequency of using this kind of control, you guys need to we need to think about the elimination first before we go down to the next hierarchy of the controls. So but this is somehow is not easy. Somehow in a practical situations, elimination, substitution is kind of impossible. So that's why people or company choose to use the simplest way to control the hazard in the factory. They usually choose the personal protective equipment. You guys can discuss later why personal protective equipment. We can discuss further that the personal protective equipment is not actually the best choice. It is, we can say it's the worst choice in any situations. Why? Because actually the personal protective equipment is only rely on the discipline, the worker discipline in wearing the equipment. Whether if the worker forget they don't pay attention about how to wear earplug in the right way, then actually the protections, the protection given by the earplug actually is not maximum for the workers. Okay, continue. If we talk about what kind of hazard that may exhibit in your company, actually there are five hazard types. First is chemical, this is the chemical, and then mechanical, noise, fire, and electricals. Maybe you can find more classifications. We'll discuss about each of them after this.